The Syrian government is denying claims it carried out a chemical weapon attack in Damascus. Opposition forces allege the poisonous gas attack killed at least 1,300 people. The Syrian National Council is calling it a massacre, and many countries are calling on the UN to take action. More on the story in just a moment. An Egyptian court has ordered the release of former President Hosni Mubarak. He could be out of jail as early as tomorrow, having recently been cleared of corruption charges. Mubarak remains on trial for the deaths of protesters during the uprising against him in 2011, as well as other charges. But no trial dates have been set, and under Egyptian law, Mubarak has already served the maximum detention. His release is likely to fuel more chaos in a country struggling with unrest. U.S. Army Private Bradley Manning has been sentenced to 35 years in prison for engineering the largest classified information leak in U.S. history. A military judge at Fort Meade, Maryland, handed down the sentence. Manning leaked hundreds of thousands of secret military files to the WikiLeaks website in 2010. Prosecutors originally asked for at least 60 years behind bars. There was fierce reaction today to news that Quebec may restrict religious symbols. The move is being widely condemned by civil rights experts. Yesterday, a Quebec newspaper reported leaked details of the PQ government's Charter of Quebec Values. One proposed section would prohibit public employees from wearing Sikh, Jewish, and Muslim headwear in the workplace. Fears are growing over a radioactive leak at the Fukushima nuclear plant. Today, Japan's nuclear watchdog upgraded the severity of the leak. It says 1 hour of exposure is equal to the maximum exposure allowed for nuclear workers over a five-year period. 3,000 tons of water have already seeped into the ground. The plant was badly damaged in the 2011 earthquake and tsunami.